this is Jennifer of Solavi Studio. Joyfully uniting nature and inspired perceptions with evolving rhythm, and welcome to my backyard. Sorry it's a bit torn up. The we removed a 33-foot deck, and it's not finished yet. It's going to take another few days. We got all the framing in, but most of the braces had to be removed because they're rotten, so there's a pile of wood, but that will get dealt with. Today I wanted to talk about solstice that's coming up. So for years I have been writing poems or just distilling my thoughts about around each turning of the year. And for the past few years, it's definitely been poems. When I started this in 2013, it wasn't just poems. So it's just a way of collecting my thoughts and making my goals more clearly defined. So every 8 times a year plus, I also write poems for the holy nights. I write a poem, and it's fun because it's all in one book, so I can go through and, oh yeah, this is what I wrote for spring equinox in 2017. Here's what I wrote for autumn equinox 2015. So this year, for solstice, this is what I wrote to try to help me focus my intention. Radiate your higher self as the sun reaches its heights. For opportunity to be manifest, sacrifice is required. Release what no longer serves you to make room for the greatest good. Tend to your fullest potential and you will receive a bountiful harvest. So action has been something that's been really coming up to me because I tend to have a lot of ideas that swirl around, but putting it into action and following through, that's always been, putting it into action is not that hard for me, but following through and completing something, that is what is hard. So my goal is to set goals and complete them. So one of the things why I have a hard time completing things, I feel, is because I get distracted. I'm working on this project and I'm going in this direction, and then all of a sudden this will come up and this will come up and this will come up. So I'll have just too many irons in the fire at the same time and not enough hours in the day. So something that came to me when I was thinking about this was this time of year, I grew up on an orchard. So this time of year, on the apples and apple trees, because my dad this weekend brought over some cherries that were just barely getting ripe from the trees. But the apple trees, they have big clusters of flowers. And so about this time of year, you'd go through, go over every single tree, and from each flowering point, there'll be clusters of 2, 3, 4 apples. So then you see which is the biggest apple and you take the rest off. So the tree can just focus on, in that particular place, putting all of its energy into that one apple, so that one apple can get really big and fully developed, instead of just having a bunch of small apples that you don't get as good of a price for, the small apples, as the big apples. So trying to distill what your main focus is, that's what I'm trying to do for this summer solstice. I'm trying to think of what my number one, my ultimate focus is, and really making sure that I spend an amount of time every single day focusing on that particular goal. But then some of the things that hold me back is the mental chatter. And that's why I love doing intentional projects. I love spinning, I love knitting, I love crocheting, I love painting, I love walking, and I used to run a lot, but not so much anymore. So my goal is to, and I always love having a summer project, a summer handwork project that can not take up much room in my luggage. So if I'm having a day at the beach, if I'm having a weekend away, if I'm traveling, then I can just have a small little project that I can work on. And I use handwork and projects like that as a time to meditate and contemplate. And usually in my project basket, I'll have a piece of paper that has something like that poem on it or something in which I'm focusing on. And then I can think about that as I'm working on it. But also what that does for me is during that time, all those little other thoughts from the ego come into your, I have this time through spinning or knitting or that sort of thing, I have the time to be aware of those ego thoughts that are popping up. And during that time, if there are thoughts that I don't like, it's a time for me, in my opinion, to retrain your subconscious. When you're meditating, when you're walking, when you're running, when you're doing something that's repetitive, that takes an amount of time. I'm a person who has a really hard time sitting still, which is why I like to do handwork. So I'm hoping that by tomorrow, I can get the rest of this wool spun. It's Falkland wool that I received as a Christmas gift. It's one of my favorite wools, so I'm hoping that this will be ready for the indigo vat tomorrow. So I have some work to do, but as I'm spinning and getting prepared, then I can think of that one big thing, that one main focus that I would like to have. And so in the next few days before the summer solstice happens, if you'd like, take some time to think of that one big thing, that one big goal, that one, I mean, whether it's, could be anything, could be eating better, could be making sure that you do anything in your life. You have the power and ability to do anything. So do so you can choose to focus on something that will bring you joy and fulfillment. Okay, blessed be.